Once again, and welcome. Transmission of what it is here in the name of peace, unconditional love, and infinite compassion. The intent of opening this space is to offer a gathering that is promoting the resonating energy to that which these words point. That which these words are symbols representing the energy of peace, unconditional love, and infinite compassion. As this construct of life continues, these three inherent qualities continue as well. They sustain life. They sustain life because they give life. They precede life. And permeate life. Accessible through stillness and silence. They are known through discovery, through being still, being quiet, keeping quiet, abiding in those two places, stillness and silence, at which point the body will become still, and since the body is a projection of primarily thoughts, and thoughts that are incorporated and perceived by and through consciousness, the thoughts become still. Meaning that there's a one-pointedness . There are fewer actual thoughts which are included in the mind, fewer concepts that are deleted, concepts that arise. And because of that, there's that silence, because there are fewer words that are said in accordance with those thoughts. They may arise, and yet they, if they arise, then they subside. Until the mind is spotless and clear. And it is said that when that happens, and also through direct experience, when that happens, there is a clarity. Literally and figuratively, there's a clarity of mind, and things become clear. The mind becomes clear, and the actions that are taken come from a deeper, compassionate intelligence. An intelligence that is trustworthy, an intelligence that is pervading, an intelligence of truth, an intelligence of unconditional love, a peaceful intelligence. Rather than a cognitive intelligence. This is the intelligence of the body, knowing that the heart can beat, the lungs can breathe on their own. In a way, it's an involuntary intelligence, just knowing what right action to take in any given situation. And usually that is in accordance with a loving, kind, caring, compassionate act. Realizing essence. Pure action, pure knowing, based on love, rather than fear, and all the things that fear brings, which are hatred, resentment, anger, animosity, all those long-lasting emotions. Even bliss. Long-lasting emotions that, or emotions that seem long-lasting but yet are temporary compared to the joy and peace that is pure to one's well-being. Sitting in that, like sitting in a warm spa, it becomes one's default, and one stays with that as the foundation of one's perception. And in abiding in such a place, there is joy, understanding, focus, gratitude, and fearlessness. There may be times when it's necessary to be pragmatic, in a sense. Yes. Yet when that happens and the actions are needed in order for the doing to take place, there is a release to allow the blessings and grace co-create in such actions or endeavors. All this emerging from the energetic infinite emptiness, the consciousness that gives rise to awareness, and the awareness that gives rise to instant, spontaneous, simultaneous form. Life being spontaneous and instantaneous. Life being one aspect of consciousness. And in that life, human beings being one aspect of that consciousness, amongst others that we know, the consciousness of animals, the consciousness of plants, the consciousness of planets, consciousness of stars being stars that emanate light and warmth and electromagnetism. All constructs arising from consciousness. Harmonically, and in seeing that harmony of what is being created, and in appreciating it, that is beauty. That is the knowing of oneness. The direct experience of oneness. Yes. It is a knowing, trusting yes. That knows itself as consciousness. Can differentiate dynamically as the interplay of form, subtleties, matter, suffering ends when this inherent peace is discovered. The story ceases to be because the beginning and the end cease to be. It's the knowing that all things, that consciousness itself is infinite. In a spaceless and timeless manner. You can say that it's infinite in time, because it is without time, you can say that it is infinite in space because it is boundless without boundaries. And all of this arises from that spontaneously. All of it. It is impossible to exclude anything that arises from consciousness. To say that something arises outside of consciousness would it arise from? Where else, other than this oneness, could anything arise? This fluctuating inner being, dynamic, differentiated oneness. How can one human being be separate from the universe? Floating in something other than this universe. How can there be any separation whatsoever? It all seems to be separated because of the perception through a body. Yet the body is connected to all that has created the body in the first place. Imagine eating a banana, this white mass of smushy substance, and that's peeled away through shedding the skin of the banana, and that banana is eaten and is transformed into nutrients. Through whatever process the body does, through digestion. It's the interplay of all that is consciousness and oneness. Same with air or anything that is taken in by the body. And also realize the things that are excluded from the body and becomes and are part of the process. The exhale, the water, the thoughts, the words, they all become part of the interplay of all that is of this oneness. And to realize that thoughts, permeate and are inclusive in this oneness. Knowing this is a realization that there are no boundaries. Thinking that a wall or a window is a boundary to a thought. That anything that is relative to anything else can actually stop the energetic expansion of that which is of its own nature, of its organic own nature. Though sunlight Though a wall may block sunlight, you can still feel its warmth. The same can be said for even a thought, in a sense. Thinking that the thought is within a brain, in a skull, that's where the thought ends. The light of the thought ends, or that it ends by a boundary of a skull, yet the warmth of it, or some other method of transmission, can continue to impact endlessly, infinitely. Or perhaps the thoughts are even prior to the thinker, and they are simply part of the gumbo of consciousness. Something to contemplate. Or allow even that thought to subside and remain abiding in the place of stillness and silence. Offer gratitude to those that are inspired to bring peace, unconditional love, and infinite compassion. Into this world. Those who have joined this gathering. Discover value in what these words point to. The inherent qualities of that are felt, they're directly experienced. Without representation, even without representation of life, of a body, of a mind. Exist upon their own right as truth. And they heal. That's the beauty of infinite compassion, that it can heal anything. Because it's infinite. It can heal anything. It can heal anything. Intent of this is to offer peace, unconditional love, and infinite compassion. These words are spoken This life is lived for this intent. Still, quiet mind. Discoveries to be revealed. Revealed by all that still and quiet the mind. The same discoveries. Of peace and unconditional love, truth, wisdom, infinite compassion, joy, objective qualities, the same treasure, the same gems in every treasure box. The same eye in which all humans can identify. That is the oneness. That is the inner beingness. That is the connection. That is the unity. The eye without any projection whatsoever. Fundamental I. Before the name, before the gender, before the race, before the ethnicity, before the philosophy, ideology, before the indoctrination, before the culture, before the recognition of time, the recognition of space, it is the spaceless, timeless, unidentifiable I that simply perceives and witnesses everything. It is that which is named awareness. Because awareness is always present as I, and is gifted by, through, and as consciousness, life, gifted as conscious beings. And knowing this, there is a light that shines upon this truth. And pervades that which is this. The infinite this, which I am, you are, we are, this is this which is. And all that is this. Energetically arising from infinite emptiness, a spaceless, timeless, infinite emptiness. When abiding in this place with a sense of sacredness and holiness, with respect, it remains as integrity. Few deviations from that integrity. one sees all that is happening as happening. Without needing to place it any way, anywhere, anyhow, because it is happening. It is happening. Pure reality. The pure function of energy happening. It's pure reality. Is to clear the mind in order to perceive without any judgment whatsoever. In a sense, any thought that is adhered, that adheres to any instant, in some way by the nature of thought, tries to qualify it. Yet pure reality is without any. Pure reality, being a process, is impossible to completely qualify, be qualified. Qualified in the sense of saying it is something specific, since it is a process. An infinite process. That's liberation. That is freedom. Freedom from the grasping by thought and holding it stagnant. And saying that this is the only thing, that this is or can ever be it form, or a thought, and subtly underlying all of this is that truth. The truth of oneness, the truth of peace, the truth of unconditional love, the truth of joy, the truths that we know to be good, that reveal joy. when remaining focused on this, reveals peace, this consciousness that reveals unconditional love. And that unconditional love that provides infinite compassion. There is great joy that comes with this. The intelligence and the clarity and the understanding. The surrender that comes with it. Surrendering that minuscule, tiny, little so-called ego, that which is incredibly far greater than anything an ego can imagine, or that imagination itself can create. It is the divine intervention of a supreme will, so-called miracles, so-called synchronizations, that have this incredibly tremendous shift. Instantaneous shift. So instantaneous that any doubt or fear that tries to permeate it is instantly shielded. That impenetrable truth. That undeniable action. It is permeating this instant. It is permeating it. Because really, where else other than now and here can it reside? It is what has given rise to what can be perceived as past. It is consciousness of which any perceived future must arise or be ridden upon or be dependent upon any outcome. The futureless outcome is within this instant. This is this. This is this. This is shared with love, with gratitude, deep appreciation, for all who hear this, understand it, know it, see it, discover it. This is sharing and gratitude. That's a gift. Do we take it in its offering, in whatever way it is to be received?